Morning, everyone. It is Sunday, March 20th, 2011, and this is your Daily Dose. I know we've been off for the last couple days, and that's because we've been busy writing and working on all the stuff that you'll see here that we're going to be going over today in our meeting. Some of the stuff you won't be seeing because it's intellectual property. That's for myself and the attorneys to look at. But for the most part, we're getting together today for a rebirth of MCCNV, if you will, and more importantly, to get back to action. Action on behalf of patients, not stagnation. So we will go ahead and jump right in with our quotes today. And our quotes today have to do with exactly that, action. And it says, the first quote from Winston Churchill says, "I never worry about action, but only inaction." And that's what these raids back in September have really done. They've pretty much put everything on like an inactive or a real cautious and a real slowdown. And it's definitely detrimental to the patients. Obviously, it's not detrimental to Metro because they're out seizing and robbing people right and left. I wish for once the media would make the police report in these stories, like how many of these raids and stuff that they're doing have resulted in convictions or have resulted in people being found to have broken the law. They need to put those numbers out there because there's going to be a lot of people that don't end up being found to have broken the law, which if that's the case and they didn't break the law, then Metro must have broke the law robbing them to begin with. So it's pretty much a common sense situation. Anyway, the point being is action is key, and rather than sit around talking to one another, we're going to get together and create action. Next quote, and it's actually a definition, and it's by Ambrose Bierce, and it says, consult, to seek approval for a course of action already decided upon. And I'm going to tell you right now, from this day forward, anybody that comes to MCCNV, me, James Parsons, for a consult or to ask me, hey, how did you get your business licenses done? How did you do this? Well, guess what? For the last 2.5 years, we told you we had a consultant's license. We let you run off, open up businesses, and watch you get raided, arrested, and then call us back and try to figure out where things went wrong. No longer will that happen. Now, we will aggressively protect our intellectual property. We will aggressively protect our trading secrets, our insider secrets, if you will. And anybody who tries to come take our information and misuse it in a way that defames or libels MCCNV will be dealt with accordingly. So good luck to all those people that think they can send in their friend to try to find out what that bearded guy's doing over there so that we can copy it too. Good luck to you. Start watching for those legal notices to show up. Next quote. Do you want to know who you are? Don't ask. Act. Action will delineate and define you. That's from Thomas Jefferson. So many people are always asking me things. How do I do this? How do I do this? How do I do this? That's not how you do it. You act. Do things. Learn from your mistakes. Do them again until you figure out what the answer is. Then you'll have the experience, the determination, and the wherewithal to be worthwhile to somebody that you might be asking those questions to. Don't ask, act. Next quote. It says, and this is from Martin Luther King Jr. It says, he who engage in nonviolent direct action are not the creators of tension. We merely bring to the surface the hidden tension that is already alive. Everything that I do is not confrontational. Everything that I do is merely bringing to surface the tension that's already there that everybody else is afraid to talk about or not willing to acknowledge and deal with at this time. MCCNV, that's not our style. When we see a problem, we deal with it. And that's what we're doing here. There's a lot of problems for medical cannabis patients, and we're going to deal with it. Which leads to the next quote by Mohandas Gandhi. It says, action expresses priorities. Well, we haven't seen a meth, coke, or heroin bust out of Metro in a long time. All we see is medical marijuana patients and the opportunity for us to have access to our medicine, regardless of the gray area that it's in. That's the only place that we've seen them focusing their efforts. Now they want to go after pimps and panderers. It's because their actions show that they're only going after seizure of assets, not going after the crime itself. All right? Next quote. There are risks and costs to action, but they are far less than the long-range risks of comfortable inaction. For 2 years, we tried to get everybody together to say, hey, if we don't stand up and fight, if we don't do this, we're going to end up, well, guess what? We ended up right where we said we were going to end up. Separate, divided, and being conquered every day. It is what it is. It's time to act. It's time to stand together and defend patients, not your profits. For all those people that went out and tried to open up stores, guess what? How many of you are rich right now? None of you. I guarantee it. None of you are. So is it worth it? Maybe for some of you it is. But oh well, we'll see what happens over the grand scheme of things, over the long run. Last quote, most important of the day. It's by Honora de Balzac, and it says, "It is easy to sit up and take notice. What is difficult is getting up and taking action." I know exactly how this felt when we filed our articles of incorporation in 2009. I know exactly how this felt when we opened our offices. When I filed our articles in 2008, November. I know exactly how it felt when we decided to open our office and take action in March of 2009. And I know exactly how it feels today when we're about to go after and take action, not only as MCCNV, but as MCCNV with legal representation and protection that's going to aggressively go after the rights that have been violated of not only myself and our organization, but of the patients we've helped. So today at 4 p.m., the rebirth, if you will, whatever you want to call it. We've been here all along. We've been the same organization. It's just now that everybody's been busted, raided, found out what they found out, can't get this help, can't find that help, found out there's nobody really supporting them, whatever the case may be. Today at 4 p.m. at the Denny's on Maryland Parkway near Sunrise Hospital, I believe it's 3081 South Maryland Parkway, at 4 p.m., we will be starting at 4 p.m. sharp. We'll be explaining who we are, what we do, and how we intend to help our members here in Las Vegas and here in the state of Nevada and here around the United States, okay? Some of the things we're going to talk about. We're going to talk about the things that we do. You know, who are we? We're going to talk about how we do them. We're going to talk about our plan of action to help you over the next few months. And we're also going to talk about how do you help? How do we get people to stop asking and start acting? We're going to go over all those things, and this will not take very long. My goal today is to basically only have to speak for, it's going to take about 20 to 30 minutes to go over what we have to go over, and then hopefully for the next 30 minutes after that, we'll have just question and answers for people that have questions. Now, keep in mind, this is a new organization. There's a lot of questions that still don't have answers, and a lot of people have learned that over the last definitely 6 months that there's not a lot of answers to be had out there from intelligent individuals. We're going to do our best, but here's what we guarantee. We guarantee that every second of every day, there is somebody in our organization that cares about what you're going through as a patient. We care about what's happening to the citizens of our state, and we care about changing it. That I can promise you. And every minute, there will be somebody from our organization dedicated to helping and informing others about what's happening here in Nevada and about what's happening abroad. So please, today, 4 p.m., the Denny's over on Maryland Parkway. If you have any questions, be sure to use the contact information that's been going across your screen the whole video, all right, to make sure that you join us today at 4 p.m. to find out what MCCNV is all about, why we're still the same as we've always been, only now people are a little bit more receptive because now we're going to do something that nobody else in Nevada has done. Not only are we going to give you an organization so you can assemble freely with like-minded individuals, but we're going to legally protect it. We're going to band together and we are going to take legal action against our aggressors and oppressors. The law is on our side, the facts are on our side, and we intend to aggressively fight for our rights. We hope to see you all at 4 p.m. today. I know it's an exciting day for me. I'm looking very much forward to doing the things that we started doing 2.5 years ago and continuing with them not only today, but well into the future. All right, everybody, this was Sunday, March 20th, 2011. This was your daily dose, and we're back at it. So make sure you're there today, 4 p.m., Denny's on South Maryland Parkway, near Sunrise Hospital, for the first open house of MCCNV since the September 2010 robberies against our charity and my home. All right, everybody, hope you have a great day. We'll see you at 4 p.m. sharp.